Welcome to another episode of Jim's Allotment Garden. Okay, so next up on the list are jalapeno chilies. Now, basically the way to grow these is you sow them into a. I'm just putting them into a small tray, because what you do is you just basically sort of drop them on, place them in across the top. All I've done is fill this with compost and then just patted it down a little piece of wood, and then all I'm going to do is spread the seeds. These seeds are from Wilco's, basically cost me £1, so there should be quite a few seeds, and 25 seeds. So I'm going to put them all in because, you know, even though these seeds are good, you know, for £1 you can't really go wrong, really. So I'm not quite sure what the germination rate is going to be, but they're basically like the little seeds that you actually see in jalapenos when you eat them, so that's kind of what they look like. And all I'm going to do is place them on top of the compost like that, and I'm going to try and obviously I know that there's 20 seeds in here, so that should be 5 rows of 4. By the look of it, I've got a few more than 20. So obviously I'm spacing them out like this because what I want to do is when I transplant them into larger pots, I want to cause the least amount of damage to the roots, or you know, disturbance to the roots. So I'm spreading them out like that. So obviously I might have a few left over at the end, which I'm just going to sprinkle. I think I'm just going to have one. Yeah, so they're about as spread out as I can get them, really. So there's just one like that. So that's kind of what they look like. And now all you need to do is put a little sprinkle over the top of compost. Now what I normally do is I've got 2 bags of compost in the greenhouse. One has been in here all winter, and another one who's basically been outside, and I've brought it into. So that's the compost that's in there now. The reason I've saved the other compost is it keeps it dry over the winter. Now, as you can see, this compost is like a browny colour, and the reason I keep this is what I can do is I put a very, very fine amount of compost over. So I've got 2 bags of compost. One is kind of wet and has been outside. Obviously it's been in the greenhouse for the past couple of weeks, but it's basically, you know, moist, which is really how you want it. But when you're doing seeds like this, you know, it's always nice to have some absolutely bone dry compost, because you can just sprinkle that over the top like that, and you can just have a fine dusting. Obviously I'm about to water it anyway, so that's you know, like a real fine coat of compost over the top. Now what I'll do is give this with the wood, just basically firm it down, and what I want to make sure is that all of the seeds are in contact with the compost. That's really important. And then what I'm going to do is water this, and then what I'll do is I'll put a little piece of glass over just to keep it warm overnight, just in case the temperature drops. But I'm going to keep this as warm as I can in the greenhouse. So what I'll probably do is leave it up here on the surface. Obviously hot air rises, so the higher up it is, the warmer it is. So I'll probably actually leave it here where I've done it. Just put a piece of glass over the top. As soon as I start to see them shooting out, take the glass off and then let them grow on. Wait till they're about 2 inches high. And then what you want to do is, just like you do with the brassicas, put your finger underneath and pull it out. Don't pull the stalk or the leaves. Put your finger underneath and lift it out like that, and the little, each one, plant that up into a larger pot. Probably something like, you know, the square pots that I use work quite well. And then you want to end up with them being in a pot that's probably about 6 inches across, and then grow them on in there. Obviously, you can grow them in sort of grow bags and stuff like that, but I'm going to be putting these into the other greenhouse, which you haven't seen yet, but I'll be filling the other greenhouse with, well, one of the things will be peppers. Okay, so next is sweet peppers. Now, I've got to be honest with you, I've grown these in the past a number of times, and I've always had mixed results. I've never had fantastic results with these, to be honest with you. But and because they're so cheap to buy in the shops, then I typically don't grow them. But I thought this year I would give it a go, and just to see how we get on, because I'm going to be putting these into the other greenhouse. So these seeds, sorry, I put that in there. These seeds come from Thompson and Morgan, as you can see. And in here, now you plant these exactly the same way as you would chillies, really. So just like we showed you last year. So basically in here, the seeds are going to be like exactly what you get in a sweet pepper, really. So you don't get many seeds for your money. So there should be 12 seeds in here. Well, there's a few more in there, but as you can see, that's what the seeds look like. So they do look incredibly like the pepper and the jalapeno seeds. So all I've done is a small tray again with some wet compost straight out the bag. And obviously I've got 12 seeds here, so that should be four rows of three. There's probably going to be more again, so what I'll do is I'll put potentially five rows in there. Oh, I've got some more in here, so that's what we've got. Right, so there's another three. This isn't exactly symmetrical. So in exactly the same way, I'm just going to spread these out a little bit more so I'm talking to you. So in exactly the same way, what I've done is I've saved some dry compost as well. So I can just sprinkle on there, because what you need is just a very light coating over the top. So again, it's just these clever composters I always use. And all I'm going to do is just basically sprinkle a little bit on the top like that, because you only want a really fine coating on top of the seeds. Spread that out like that. Now again, like other plants, these are going to come out and they're going to look very similar to the jalapeno seeds I've just put in. So obviously make sure that you put a label on. Again, just firm them down like that with a piece of wood. And then give them a bit of tap water and then they'll be ready to go. So what I'll do, I'll basically have those like that alongside the jalapeno seeds that I've got, so obviously that makes a tray's worth. And then I'll be putting a piece of glass over the top. So all you need to do is put the label on the side like that, and then put a piece of glass over like that, as I've explained to you in the past, with a bit of wood. Just put that underneath like that, because what you don't want is it to be scorched. You want to keep the warmth in there, but you don't want too much warmth. So if you just put something underneath the glass at one corner or in the edge like that, what it'll do is it'll let a little bit of ventilation so it doesn't get too hot in there. As soon as you see the seedlings coming out, remove the glass. Don't leave the glass on there, otherwise if the leaves of the seedlings touch the glass with the humidity, you can get like a lens effect and the sun will burn the leaves. So right, so that's the pepper and the jalapenos. Okay, so I'm just putting the strawberries in, and what I've done is I've dug the ground over, loosened it all up, levelled it all off, raked it off. This is where the potatoes were last year, so I've got the, so just so you know where you are, this is the espalier trees here. And what I've done is I've put 2 metres of fleece down. I've sewn it up the middle. I don't know if you can see the crease up the middle there, but that's where I've sewn it together. And then at each end, I've put it underneath the slabs on this side to hold it nice and taut. And I've put it under the slabs at the other end as well, so it's now nice and taut across the ground. I let the ground settle down overnight after I dug it, so it, you know, so it won't drop any further and make the cloth go slack. And what I've done is I've stretched a bamboo cane across here to another stick there, so I don't have to make any holes in the fleece. And I've strung five strings across to exactly the same thing on the other side. I've got another piece of bamboo there. And now what I can do now is I can see exactly where the strawberry plants need to be planted in here. So I'll be planting on this first row here, I'll be planting three, then on the next row two, and then three, two, three, two, three, two, as I'm going up there, so until I fill it. So unfortunately, the strawberries that I took the runners off last year, the slugs nobbled most of them in the greenhouse over the winter, but I've managed to salvage these four here. And so what I'm going to be doing is transferring the strawberries from the existing strawberry bed, which is just here. As you can see, the plants are just about starting to come now. So ideally what I would do is leave this another few weeks till the plants have really started to grow. In addition to that as well, I'll be able to take off any of the leaves that are got any spots on them, because that's basically a disease. But because the weather's nice at the moment, I'm going to make hay whilst the sun shines, and I'm going to be digging the strawberry plants out of here and effectively transferring them over to the new position there. And then I'll be able to dig this bed over here and sort of clear it all out. And I'll be putting the onions, or at least some of the onions, here this year. So I'm going to be digging some good organic material into the ground here, because the strawberries have been here about 4 years now, and this ground is most certainly exhausted. So as I say, I'll transfer the strawberries from here into the new position where there were potatoes last year, dig all this over and dig some muck in and some wood chip and some good rotted down compost, and then get this all up and get all the weeds out and get all this nice and clear. Then I can put the onions in this position here for this year, and then next year I may or may not transfer them back to here. I may leave them there for a couple of years and then transfer them back here. But that's the plan anyway. So I just wanted to show you how I was putting them in, and as soon as I've got them in, I'll show you what it looks like. Okay, so the easiest way I've found to do this is, the first thing you need is a scalpel. What you want to do is cut through the cloth where you're going to put the plant. So obviously the first one's going to go here, the second one's going to be just off the shot here on the third string, and then the next plant will be over here on the second string. So in the first row there's going to be effectively three strawberry plants. So all I'm going to do, position the stick, knowing that it's parallel with the rest of the row, and then if I then cut through the cloth, this is where the scalpel really helps. Now, you don't want a massive hole, you only want a hole big enough. Obviously I'm putting a plant in out of a pot like that, so I only want the hole to be as big as the pot is, really. Now you can do this one or two ways. This next bit, you can either just with your hand put your hand in like that and pull the ground back to one side, or just by using a trowel. Obviously you need a small trowel. And all I'm going to do is basically push out the strawberry plant, so I've got a nice good rootstock on there. Obviously you're aiming to plant it so it's at the same level as the cloth, and then as soon as you've done that, just push the soil back around it, putting your hands inside the cloth like that, and then a good firm down like that. Try and break any stones that are near it or any clumps of dirt, and then that's your strawberry plant in place. So I'll just do the next one along so you can see what I'm talking about. So I'll just position the camera down slightly. So this is the next one here. So the next one will go here, which is just at the bottom of your screen. So what I'm going to do is make sure I'm in line, cut through the cloth that way and that way. So that's where the plant's going to go. So you only need a hole about that big. You don't need anything bigger than that. The smaller the hole, the better, really, as long as the plant can get through it. And then just put your fingers in, and then you're making a hole inside there, which is basically the same as what you've taken out of the pot, and then just force that through into the ground. Obviously the ground's just been dug, so it's nice and loose anyway, so you should be able to do that quite easily. Force it in like that, push it in, and then just push the ground down round it, and then that's your strawberry plant ready. As soon as I've finished putting all of these in, what I'll do is I'll go back and give them a water, so they've got a bit of water to start off with. Okay, so one job that we can be getting on at this time of year is putting the dahlias in there. The dahlias have been, I uprooted them last year, and I've had them upside down drying. I've left as much soil on, more than I do normally really, because I didn't want to damage the tubers. But you can see that the tubers are perfectly healthy in there. There's none that are soft or sort of damaged. And what we need to do now is start them off in a pot in the greenhouse or in the shed, till they start to shoot, and then they can be planted out in a month or so's time. So the easiest thing to do is you need a pot that's more than big enough, really. You know, it needs to be, big enough so that the dahlia easily sits in there. And all we need to do is put some fresh, this is clover compost. You need to put about 3 inches in, 3 inches in the pot at the bottom. And then just tease the roots a little bit just to get them spread out like that, and then sit it so that it's about 2 or 3 inches off the top of the pot. And then all we need to do then is just put the clover compost around the edge, and what you need to make sure is sort of do that with your fingers around the edge to make sure that that all the roots are covered with compost. And obviously what this compost is going to do is it's going to give us a real boost. Now, dahlias are quite hungry plants. They like a lot of nutrients in the soil, and putting them in compost like this, particularly clover, there's a lot of sort of richness in there, and that'll get it off to a start. So as you can see, I've planted it up to just about the same height as it was last time. So the shoots are just coming out. A lot of these shoots here are pretty much dead. So the new shoots are going to be coming from the bottom of the plant. So what I'll do is, rather than cut these off now, I'll wait for the new shoots to come, and then I can cut these old ones off as soon as I know that they are definitely dead. So give that a really good soaking in water, and you want to keep it absolutely frost free, either in a shed, it doesn't necessarily got to be in the light, it obviously needs some light, but I'm just going to put these in the greenhouse for now, and try and keep them frost free, give them plenty of water, because obviously what you need to do is rehydrate the roots so that so they start growing. So I'm going to just do that with the rest of them now, and then give them a really good watering, and then they'll be shooting in the next few weeks. Okay, so some seeds that we can be putting in now we've got to the end of March are the gourds. Now I'm going to be growing a number of gourds this year, but I am going to be growing the ones that I always grow. Now this is the pumpkins that I'm going to grow, pumpkins being the biggest gourd now, or one of the biggest gourds should I say. Now I grew these last year, those are the seeds there. The thing that you need to remember with gourds is the seeds only last really for 1 year. So as you can see here, it says packed at the May 2015, last till December 2016. So these seeds are really no good now. So you always really need to get fresh seeds. And the one thing that I will say is, if you're going to save gourd seeds, make sure that you've got the plant that you take it off has got no other gourd anywhere near it, because these things cross. Cross-pollinate with each other, and you end up with all kinds of weird, if you've got a pumpkin and a courgette next to each other, you'll end up with something between the two. You won't end up with pumpkin seeds, even though the seeds come from a pumpkin. So my advice would be always buy them new. So all you need to do is take the seed, there's the seed, and all I've got here is some little square tubs. And I've got the compost, put the seeds down, I've got the compost almost to the top. This is sort of quite loose. And if you hold the seed kind of sideways like that, all you need to do is push it in to the pot and get it about kind of 2 inches down. I don't know if you can see that. Then all you need to do is push the ground round it and firm it down like that. And what you should end up with, if you've done it right, is the soil or the compost should be around half an inch below the top. The reason I use square pots is it stops the roots getting pot bound, and these are going to be in here till they're reasonably big. So you need to, these pots are more than big enough. But the other point I would say as well is, because you're going to get new seeds every year, you're probably going to get more seeds than you need. I'm only going to put 8 plants in here, and I've got about, I don't know, 15 seeds or so. So pick out the biggest seeds, because they're the ones that are going to potentially give you the best plant. So obviously, if any seeds look a little bit funny or something like that, then you know, always go for the nice big fat seeds. They're the ones that are going to give you the strongest plants. So that's all of the that's all 8 seeds in. All I've done basically is just pushed it down like that in my hands. You can't really see. The other thing you can do is get one pot and push it into the others like that. Obviously, with all gourds, until they actually start to fruit, it's incredibly difficult, if not impossible, to tell them apart. So what you always need to do is label them up, because just like brassicas, they all look the same until they get a bit older. With gourds as well, obviously pumpkins have slightly bigger leaves, but the first leaves, by the time you plant these in the ground, they'll effectively be identical. So I've got label with pumpkins on. Now all I need to do now is give them a bit of water, and they'll sort of grow happily away. Things with like courgettes and butternut squashes, exactly the same thing. With butternut squashes, you don't tend to get anywhere near as much seeds. There's only probably about, there's 8 seeds in there, which is more than enough for me. And courgette plants, obviously, I would tend to grow a few more plants than you need. Then you can pick the strongest plant and put it in, and obviously give away the other plants that you don't need, because these seeds won't be any good next year. So you might as well put them in. A few more than you actually need. Okay, quick update on how things are going. So here the broccoli, as you can see, they're about an inch or so high now. All of these across here are the spinach. I've just actually noticed something's had a nibble of that there, so I don't know what's done that. I don't know if you can see that one there. It looks like it's been nibbled. That's the Alicante just coming through now, and the money maker are coming through. As you can see, there's less of them. They're the sweet peas coming through there, and these are the asparagus peas. Just see 3 of them. That one there, fourth one's just sort of coming through. So that's the greenhouse. Obviously, there's not a lot going on in here, but the grapevines just starting to throw out shoots, as you can see. So that's doing well. Those are the dahlias that I put in earlier, and the peppers. The seeds have come to the surface. Sometimes, if you do that, you just need to bob them back under like that. So that's the greenhouse. Sort of out here, I do need to cut the mint down there, but the rosemary is doing really well. It's covered in these little flowers at the moment, which the insects love. All the bits and bobs going on here. Obviously, the mint's growing there. That's the sage there, and the oregano has just started to come through. Okay, coming around here, the chives are growing really well. What I have noticed is a couple of them have gone curly, and that's the allium leaf miner. So what I'm going to do, now I've shown you, is I'm going to pull all those off and get rid of them. The asparagus has not started to come through yet, but I'm expecting that to come through in the near future. Comfrey is started to come through really well. I've started to cut down the raspberries, and I've got to about here. So what I'm doing is taking out all the old wood like this. That's like an old one, you can tell by the look of it. It's got like a silvery. When you get to this time of year, if you wait till now, you'll start to see the shoots coming on here. So obviously that one's a good one. This one's got no shoots on it, so take that one out basically. So what I've been doing is working my way along, cutting out all the dead ones and leaving the ones with shoots on, because those are the ones that will give me some fruit. You've probably seen the strawberry clip. I'm not sure if I put that in this video or not, but I've just got to there. The reason I've stalled on that is the strawberries haven't quite all started to grow yet, so I'm giving that a couple of weeks till these have got a few more leaves on them. As you can see, they are growing, but what I want to do is wait till they've really started to grow, and then I'll transplant them straight over. So that's that bit. Coming down here, so what I've done here is I've dug all over the where the potatoes are going to go. I've got some muck here, which is going to be spread over from the chickens. I was planning to rotivate this today, but unfortunately the rotivator broke on me, so I'm in the processes of fixing that. So that's the this has all been dug over the last week, dug all that, and then all the potatoes will be going here and where this tunnel is, or at least part of where this tunnel is. So the potatoes will start there and be all the way down to probably about halfway along this tunnel. We're still picking kale from in here. As you can see, I've been pulling the leaves off. It is running to seed now, but I'm deliberately leaving this to run to seed, because what I want to do is save the seed off. This is the Scottish kale here, and this is the Petrarch kale at the back. So I've left these two Petrarch kales in because what I want is to collect the seed from these. I need to dig this bit over here inside, and the tunnel is about to move that way. So as soon as these have run to seed, the tunnel will be moving, basically. Because if I take the tunnel off from there, the pigeons are likely to eat it all. So I've dug all over here and rotivated. So that's all been dug. Got all the weeds out and all the rest of it. And then I've rotivated around. It needs tidying up a little bit. There's still a few weeds here and there. But that's all been rotivated today. Now it's dry. So this is basically where all the brassicas will be grown this year. So this tunnel will move down to here, and then in the next couple of weeks, and then I'll be planting out the brassicas in here. But what I wanted to do was dig it over now, so that I don't have to rotivate inside the tunnel, which is dangerous. So so that's all ready to go now. As you can see, the rhubarb's really started to come on. So that'll be shooting up. The next time you see this, probably next week, it'll be right up over the top of this. It grows really quickly this time of year. So that's the rhubarb. Excuse me. In the second tunnel here. Now this tunnel's going to stay here this year as well. I'm not going to move this tunnel. But what I am going to do is grow non-brassicas in here. So I'll be growing things like spinach and things like that in here. I can grow brassicas this side because I didn't grow them last year, but most certainly where these are here, I shan't be growing brassicas. But this is some more Scottish kale. I've not been picking this as much as the other because I'm obviously trying to move that tunnel over. But that's the second tunnel. Right, and what I've done around here is I've just very quickly dug out, I've taken out all the old sunflowers and dug this border along here. Obviously I'll have the calendula. As you can see, they're already starting to come through, so this will all be calendulas along here. And then I've rotivated all of this here, and this is where effectively the beans will be, right the way along here, up to about here, which will be at the back of the tunnel. So the beans will be from about where we are here right the way down to the end there, or at least the broad beans will be here. I'm going to be putting some this bit here, which will be kind of trapped behind the beans. I'll be putting some pumpkins there because they grew well there last year, and then the rest of the pumpkins will kind of be in the other gourds, and that'll be kind of in the middle here as soon as this tunnel's moved. So that's a really quick look around of what the allotment looks like. The reason why I've done the tour is just so you can see how I'm preparing the ground. And what I'll be doing is, I'll be putting all the chicken manure all over here, which is where the potatoes are going to go. I'm also going to be putting quite a lot of rotted down wood chip, which is what I collected last year, and I've had that in bags since last year. So that'll be going on here, which is obviously moisture retentive. So that'll all be dug in here. And then as soon as I've got all that spread over here, I'll be rotivating all of this and where the tunnel is now to put the potatoes in. So all of that will be happening in the next couple of weeks. So probably the next time we see this, that tunnel will have moved. I may well do a video clip of me moving that so you can see how easy it is. And then I'll get all this rotivated, and I can start to put the stuff in. But that's what the allotment looks like at the back end of March. Obviously these are the strawberries here, so I'm planning to put the onions here this year. So as soon as the strawberries have moved from here to over there, I'll dig all this out, and then this will be onions. There'll probably be more onions in the other part as well, but I think this will be onions here. So that's what the allotment looks like. So, I hope this episode was of some use to you. Please don't hesitate to put any comments or questions you've got below, and I'll always get back to you. And I'll see you on the next episode of Jim's on the Garden.